booty, 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 hooty. That was a welcome from our Swedish chef from Muppets in Space. Welcome back, Space Rangers, and welcome to all our scouting family. This is our welcome back breakfast that we're going to prepare this morning, and we're going to make pancakes. So what we're going to do is we're going to set out the ingredients and the stuff that we need, and then you can pause and go away and get the stuff, and then we are going to come back and we'll do our mixture and get that all ready to cook, and then we'll pause again, and then we'll do the cooking process, and then we'll have a final pause, and then we'll do the cleaning up at the end, which is, of course, ask your parents, that's the most important bit of all. So what we're going to do is, during this process, I'm going to slip in a few space movies for you to spot, and by the end, let's see how many that you've managed to spot. So if you're a beaver, then you can help an adult in the household do all this process. If you're a cub, then you can probably manage most of it yourself. You might want to get an adult help with the cooking, or if you're a scout, I'm sure you can do the whole process yourself. So what we're going to do is we're going to start by looking at all the kit. Now, you don't need a chef's hat like mine, because quite frankly, I look a bit like a Wally. But hey, I'm sure you'll manage without a chef's hat. Okay, so the kit that we're going to need going forward is, you're going to need some scales to measure your and weigh your stuff. You're going to need some measuring spoons. So we've got a tablespoon measurement here and a teaspoon measurement here. We've got a bowl, a sieve and a whisk to mix our ingredients with. We've got a jug that you might want to use to pour your ingredients once you've got them mixed. We've got a pot to do some melting of the butter, some bowls to hold ingredients. You're going to need some sort of flat instrument, so you're going to need a frying pan or a skillet or something like that to actually make your pancakes on. And you're going to need a fish slice, a knife and some other kit like that. The other thing I've got there at the front there is a measuring drum, because you're going to have to measure your liquids going forward. So that's the kit that you need going forward. And we'll move on to the ingredients. Don't worry, I'll repeat the ingredients as we're putting them in the bowl in the next bit. So on here, what we've got is we've got self-raising flour, so we need 200 grams of self-raising flour. We need baking powder, and we need 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder. We've got sugar. Now, you can either use golden caster sugar or just caster sugar, and that's 1 tablespoon. You need butter, 25 grams, or margarine. You need some vegetable oil for cooking. If you wish, you can use butter or vegetable oil. I like to use a bit of both. You need some milk, so you're going to need 200 milliliters of milk. You need some salt. We use low salt here. And you're going to need 3 large eggs. So that's the ingredients that you're going to need. You can also put some fruit in your pancakes while you're making them. So we've got some examples here. We've got some blueberries, we've got banana, we've got apples. Personally, I would peel them and chop them before I put them in the mixture, because you can end up with a funny sized pancake if you don't do that. You've got various other toppings. You've got peanut butter, if you like peanut butter. You've got honey, you've got maple syrup. For those that are vegan, you've got maple syrup instead of honey. We've got this jam, this space jam here. This particular flavour is raspberry, but you can use any that you want. So there's a variety of stuff you can have on your pancakes. So that's the kit that you need, and that's the ingredients that you need. So we're about to pause the video so you can go away and get all your stuff ready. Now, before we do anything else, what we need to do is we need to firstly wash our hands, if you haven't done it already. So make sure you wash your hands thoroughly and sing Happy Birthday twice. I'm sure you're very familiar with that. And the second thing is, if you are wearing a neckie, which you might well be, you need to either take your neckie off, or you need to tuck your neckie inside your apron that you're wearing. Now, I've worn this special woggle holder, the Star Wars figure, in because this is obviously a space camp. So I'm just going to tuck my necky in so it's well out the way, and obviously I've already washed my hands thoroughly because I've got my ingredients ready. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put our dry ingredients in the bowl. So we're going to start with the self-raising flour. I always like to sieve the flour because I think you get a better pancake if you've sieved your flour. So here's your 200 grams of self-raising flour. Just help it through with a spoon. And you've got your baking powder, your 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder. That goes in as well. So that's them both sieved. And you've got 1 tablespoon of caster sugar that you can add as well. Now the butter, I've melted the butter. Now I did it in the microwave just for 30 seconds, or you can do it in a pot. It depends what's easiest for you. And I've measured out 200 milliliters of milk here. Now the eggs, there's 3 eggs. Now what I always do with eggs is I like to break the eggs individually into a little bowl, because sometimes you get a rogue one and it can be a bit bad. And what you don't want to do is spoil all of your ingredients. So next we're going to add the eggs after we've cracked them and put them in a separate bowl. So crack the egg into a bowl. Make sure it's a good egg, because it could be Armageddon if it's an old rotten egg. And we do that with all 3 eggs. So we're adding all 3 of our eggs into our ingredients. So there's the 3 eggs in. So we're basically now adding our wet ingredients. We're going to add our 200 milliliters of milk, and we're going to add our 25 grams of melted butter. Now the only other thing to go in at this stage is a little pinch of salt. So I'm just going to add a pinch of salt, and that's all our ingredients in the bowl. Now what we want to do is we want to get a whisk, and we want to whisk it up. Now a wee tip, what we don't want to do is over whisk the mixture, and basically whisk it until it's all well mixed and then stop. Okay, because that way you get fluffier pancakes that will rise better. So I'm just mixing this up with a whisk, making sure that all the flour especially is mixed in and that there's no lumps. So there we go. We've got a nice mixture. It's all nicely mixed together. And we're just about ready for the next stage. Okay, we'll start with part 3, which is the interesting bit, obviously, when we get to do the cooking. What I've done is I've left a tea towel out on the counter, so when we've finished our pancakes, we can bring them across, put them on the tea towel, and just put the tea towel over the top until we've cooked them all, and that keeps them nice and warm and moist. Now, I showed you in part 2 the mixture that we've made there, but if you remember in part 1 I said you could put other stuff in, so you could add Astra, you could add blueberries at this stage. If different family members want different stuff, then you could separate the mixture and put some fruit in one bit of the mixture and keep just the normal pancake mixture on the other. It's entirely up to yourselves. So I've got a ladle I'm going to use to put the pancake out, and I've got my fish slice. So we're going across here where I've preheated my hob, and what I've done is I've just put a little knob of butter on. I've let it melt, and look, it's nice and warm. It really needs to be quite warm before you start putting pancakes on. You usually find when you're making pancakes, the first one is a bit of a disaster, and it always looks a bit like an alien. So don't worry if the first one isn't as good, give it to your mum and dad. The ones after that are usually much better. So I'm going to take a quantity of pancake mix, and I'm going to pour it on here, and I'm just going to let gravity work its way, or work the mixture out And it's really up to you how big you want your pancakes, but that's probably enough mixture for one pancake. Okay, put the mixture aside, and then we're just going to let it cook. And what you're looking for when your pancake is cooking is on the surface you'll see bubbles start to appear. And when bubbles start to appear, that lets you know that the underside is probably just about ready. So it does take a few minutes. Okay, so if we look at the pancake now, we can see some of the bubbles starting to appear. When they start to appear, what you can do is just lift, put your fish slice underneath and just lift up and have a peer to see, and that looks pretty good to me. So now I'm going to flip that over. So just get the fish slice underneath and flop it straight over. And there we go. Look at that. We've got a nice golden pancake underneath. So I'm going to do one more for the video, but this time what I'm going to do is another option is once I've put my pancake in, I'm just going to add some blueberries into the top of the mixture just to make a slightly healthier pancake. Okay. So again, just letting gravity pull the mixture out of your spoon, and there we go. And it's, you can tell it's a lot hotter this time. You can see some of the smoke coming up, so this should cook fairly quickly. So I'm just going to get some blueberries. This will be a lovely blueberry pancake. And there we go. And we'll let that cook in the same process we did in the first one. Okay, and just to finish up, you can see you can do more than one pancake in your pan at one time. So I'm doing three there. So once we're cooked, then we'll get to have to eat them for our delicious breakfast, and we'll be back for part four. Okay, on to part four. We've had the best bit where we've managed to scoff all our delicious pancakes for our breakfast. We're now on to the clearing up. So let's see who can do it as fast as me, because I reckon I can go around here as fast as an extraterrestrial, and I'm going to be the first man finished, or first boy or first girl. So let's see if you can keep up with me.